Hello, my name is Pavel, and today, if you can't tell, we're in a different type of setting. And this setting is basically my mom's house. Well, it's my house, but I've been living in my own apartment for the last like 3 months, and I still live there, but I decided to come back and visit my mom. And I was like, you know what, maybe I will show my channel my setting, because this is the room that I basically kind of grew up in. Like, we've been living in this house for like, I think it's been like 15 years or something like that, and everything that I've kind of like, the ideas I've thought and the hobbies I've come up with, like all my exams I've studied for here, like everything about me, everything about my character, all of that sort of shit has kind of formulated here. And this room used to be covered in emo posters. I'll try get a photo, but I have no idea if I can, but it used to be covered in a lot of like emo posters. And then I slowly changed the room to like, I don't know, make it more about myself. But like, the older that I become, the more like even more cringy it gets. Like, I have a massive like Guardians of the Galaxy poster. Like, I do like that, but I don't think I would hang that up right now. I love this room, and like, I'll put in a load of videos here of everything around from this room. Yeah, I thought I'd make like a vlog. Hopefully I'll watch some movies, but I'll show you here. We do not have our TV because we moved it to the apartment. So I have this like tiny little thing, so I don't really know. I'll have a think, but I'll still try and make this like vlog about watching movies and all that sort of shit, if you know what I mean. But mostly I'll just take you around my day, because I'm here for a few days. And hopefully, you know, you'll get a different taste of like my life, because it's definitely different to my apartment. But it's also really funny, like every single time I come here, I usually use it as like a time gauge. Like, I measure time with when I come here and when I leave. Last time I was here, I didn't have a YouTube channel. We hadn't even properly moved into the apartment. I remember coming here gradually, like over summer and winter, and be like, okay, will I have an apartment next time I'm here? Will I have this sorted next time I'm here? Will I have this sorted by the next time I'm here? And I don't know, it's just really cool. Like, the next time I come here, hopefully life will be different. But like, I love everything right now. But it's still interesting for me to think about it that way. And it's also really nice to see mom and see, like, if I get a chance to actually see my friends and just relax. Because I try to chill here, because I feel like I'm always stressing in my apartment. Also, if you can see here, there's a huge bike. That's my girlfriend's Christmas present, and I know it's April, but we're finally gonna bring it to our apartment, so do not judge, please. There was a huge TV here, but it's a tiny one now. Not that it matters. I'm just kind of showing you around the room. Up here, I'll try to get a better video, but it has like a load of random like DVDs, and like a load of, there's like a signed Andy Biersack photo that I remember I sent a letter to his dad, be like, can I get a signed photo of Andy? And he actually sent me one back. I used to collect Christmas cups. They're somewhere up there. I used to collect Christmas cups from Costa. I also collected like all my techie bits, like my techie boxes, from like my Switch, my camera, my speaker. Don't know why I did it, don't ask. Then behind me, which is my favorite kind of thing, so let me show you that. Okay, so I don't know if you can see that properly, but there's basically a huge wall of prints, and this is kind of like my pride and joy. I remember making this, and it took me so long. I remember like doing two lines out a week in a week, and then doing more and more and more, and this wall took me so long to actually finish. And then we have another wall. We have a Tyler the Creator poster, Back to the Future, 1975, Bri-Bri, does anyone remember Bri-Bri? Fair play if you do. Then we have a Dodie poster over there. Let me try to show you over there. And then I have a wall full of like random shit, like concert tickets and all that sort of stuff. Then I have a drawing by my girlfriend and some of my own photography. This room is packed with like memories and stuff that I really, really love. And I remember making this room because we obviously changed it from it being really emo. Put up some wallpaper and painted it, and I was like, right, I'm gonna try my best. Just capture my personality in one single fucking room. And this is what happened. Just a mess of stuff clung together, but I still really love this room. Like, I think it looks really cool. Hopefully you've gotten a little bit of a sense of my room. And kind of like my personality growing up in like the teenage years. I think if you watch like all the videos on my channel, you'll slowly like be able to formulate the type of person I was in those years, you know, if that makes any sense. But yes, I'm gonna go get on with my day, and I'll keep you updated, and I'll show you everything. Let's not get ahead of ourselves, and let's go have a good day. So be right back. Okay, you need to ignore the hair, because I washed it and I put like very little product in it, so that's why it looks like a fucking hectic thing. I don't really know what you would explain it, but anyway, I just watched a movie on this TV. It was a French movie, and I okay, I do not know how to speak French, as you already know from my previous videos, but the movie was called Le Jeu. Let me actually get my phone and try to like, pronounce it a bit better. It was called Le Jeu, but anyway, in English, which I can actually speak, believe it or not, it's called Nothing to Hide, and the synopsis for this movie reads, to spice up a dinner party, old friends agree to share every private message that pops up on their phone with disastrous results. In theory, I was like, you know what, this sounds really fucking fun. I did not want anything too hectic, I just wanted something to watch that I could enjoy, and you know what, I always want to watch more foreign movies, I always want to watch more French movies especially, so I was like, you know what, this sounds so fucking good, and I really did like it. In concept, everybody at a dinner table, just putting down their phones and reading every message, email, notification, anything that comes up sounds so scary. But then when I thought about it in reality, imagine I just set my phone down here for like 2 hours, 3 hours or whatever. Genuinely, one or two snaps and that's it. I don't think I'm getting that many messages. So I think in reality, if you're a poppin' person, maybe this would be exciting. But I think if you're anything like me, I don't think it would be too hectic. But seeing this happen in a movie, obviously it made it a lot more fun, aka this was a 90-minute movie where everybody's life slowly falls apart. And I enjoyed it. I was like, how are they gonna squeeze everything into 90 minutes and kind of make this work? And you know what? They did to an extent. The last 10 minutes, generally the ending I just didn't like at all. But you know what? I'm not gonna spoil why I didn't like the ending, but I still think it's worth watching like the first 80 minutes and still watch the remaining 10. But just, if you could separate the first 80 minutes and the last 10 minutes, then I think you'll enjoy this movie a lot more. You genuinely do like the characters, and there are so many scenes in this that do kind of make you feel extremely anxious, and you're like, oh fuck, is this wife gonna find out this? Is the husband gonna find out this? And you know what? I found it really interesting that they try find like a balance between realistic and unrealistic. Like, they weren't getting a million calls from like a million partners, but there's obviously someone cheating and there's obviously something happening to somebody else. If you want to watch someone kind of fuck up their life and their marriage and their relationship and their future, then definitely give this movie a watch. I'm in my living room now, but I remember it being like mid-lockdown, the first lockdown, and I just used to come down to the kitchen whenever mom was in bed, put on my headphones and just dance in the kitchen in the dark, and I know that is so depressing, but I have like just this like vivid memory of me having my headphones on and being like jamming up to, I think it was like the 1975 or like The Tallest Man on Earth, and then just having my headphones on and going crazy, and it's just so weird to kind of think back on that. I don't really know why. I'm currently listening to the John Green book, The Anthropocene Reviewed, and he's kind of like writing that mid-2020, and it just made, I don't know, made me kind of like, you know, look back on everything, and it's just kind of interesting. Hello, so I've just watched another movie, and I'm so ready for bed, but before I go to bed, I'm gonna tell you about an Irish movie that I watched, which was so nice, because I feel like I rarely watch Irish movies. And this movie is called Redemption of a Rogue. And the synopsis for this movie reads, in this dark comedy, a prodigal son returns to his hometown to see his estranged father before he dies. But earning his salvation proves complicated. Yes, okay, so this is actually really weird. Tomorrow we're going to my girlfriend's house in Donegal, and sorry, I keep fixing my hair. I really should have done something with it before I actually filmed. But the place where this movie is filmed is like the main street, it's in Cavan, and the street that we drive past, like we go on the road where this movie was filmed. So it was like so weird being like that, like they've changed the sign just for that movie. And also, like 5 minutes into this movie, there is a Garda car, which is like the Irish police. And I do not like the way in movies, they just kind of completely alter the uniform and alter their car and everything. Is it just because like a copyright type? I don't know. It just feels like it looks nothing like the Garda uniform in Ireland, but I could be completely wrong and there could be a reason for that. So apologies if I'm wrong, but this movie was definitely really interesting. One thing I did not expect was this movie to be so like aesthetically pleasing. Like there are times where like the story kind of suffers because of like the stylistic choices, but overall they killed it. Like there's many times throughout this movie where they move throughout time, and this film just depicts it so lovely, and it looks really beautiful. And there are times where I'm like, okay, why is there so many jump cuts? Why is this movie edited so fast in this one scene? Like, what is happening? I do not understand. But aside from that, it was definitely very interesting. I just randomly saved this on Netflix and I was like, okay, let's see what this is about. And it's 90 minutes. Also, as you can see, I have like this weird fascination for 90 minute movies. I think it's just like the perfect spot for a movie. But now I'm gonna just quickly speak about the sound in this movie. I feel like there's like a clear emphasis on like every single noise in like the kitchen, for example. Like you see the two brothers and they are just moving and drinking tea, and you hear every gulp, every creak of the chair, you hear absolutely fucking everything, and it's just weird. I don't know, I do not want to hear here when you're drinking tea. I do not want it. Also, one more thing that I forgot to mention, I feel like this movie captures really well how kind of like how men are so awkward at forming relationships between each other, and how awkward they are when they want to express feelings and like suppressed emotions, and just kind of seeing that displayed on screen was definitely really interesting. Like it definitely highlights that there's like a societal struggle for men to clearly express their feelings, especially to one another, to their loved ones, and just everything that's actually happening, and they just kind of like soak it all in. I don't really know how to properly explain it, but I feel like that movie captures that feeling really well. I don't know if I'm explaining it correctly, but there is a point I'm trying to hint at, and it's somewhere in what I've just said, but I hope that kind of made a little bit of sense. Also, there's a character throughout this movie called Masha. I think it also highlights very well how a person who's foreign just kind of feels like a pariah within a town, especially a very like culty rural town. I cannot fucking say that word, but I feel like it really highlights how like they are definitely seen as an outcast because of where they are from, and the general like attitude towards them is just hatred. And I've experienced it with people and family around me, so I feel like this movie really highlights that very well, especially in Ireland. I just wanted to quickly throw in that point, that those two quick little points. Hello. Huh. We are finally back. Ignore the hair. We have so much shit. I do not even know. We went to both of our houses and we came back with so many bags and a whole ass bike. So I'm gonna go, you know, clean all this up, and then I'll go watch a movie and I'll just chat about it and probably conclude the vlog then. So be right back. It'll be really quick for you, but it's gonna take me so fucking long. Hello. So I have finally put away all of my stuff. I put away the bike. But you know what I was like? I was like, I'm gonna watch one more movie before I go to bed, because you know, I kind of like doing these watch movie with me vlogs and watching three-ish movies. And I was like, you know, let's watch something chill on Netflix. And we flicked through Netflix and we were like, what will we watch? And we just wasted, sorry. We watched a movie called Choose or Die. And before I complain and get angry over this movie, let me quickly read you the synopsis of this fantastic movie. So, the synopsis reads, tempted by a chance to win unclaimed prize money, two friends reboot a mysterious 1980s video game and step into a surreal world of next level terror. This movie was the lowest level terror I have ever seen in my fucking life. By the title, I was like, this is gonna be shit. But then I saw the cast and I was like, Asa Butterfield is in it. And I was like, you know what? I really like him. The title sounds like shit, but I've never heard of this movie. Maybe I'll give it a little bit of a chance and he could prove me wrong, but it did not fucking prove me wrong. It was such a waste of time. This movie can't even reach 90 fucking minutes. It was that bad. Nothing. I have to take my hood off because I'm genuinely getting annoyed. There's nothing good about this movie. He's in it for like 20 minutes. The story is all over the place. There are random characters in this movie that just, why are they there? There's no place for them to be there. They're just kind of in there to kind of add to the story, because like, I feel like they just sat down and they brainstormed this and they're like, right, what if we take the stereotypical tropes of a horror movie, chuck them into kind of like a film, make it a little bit dark, use skulls as the main kind of logo because we have nothing else to use, because skulls are the most original fucking thing we can use apparently, And we're just gonna peg it all into a 90-minute movie that's targeted to, I don't know, who is this movie fucking targeted towards? There's nothing. The only good thing I will say about this movie is that there's some scenes that look really nice. Aside from that, nothing. There's four challenges in this game, and after you do them, you've beat the game, choose or die game, and apparently only one person has bet this game, apparently. Four challenges, yes, the challenges are a bit like, dumb. They're dumb, because all you have to do is like, pick who dies. I know that sounds like I'm just like, being like, oh, you just pick who dies or whatever. No, it's just, oh, everything about this movie just sucked. And I feel like I've never gave out about a movie this much, but you're really seeing the true side of me in this vlog. me getting angry over a movie. Like, they've probably put millions into this and it's just wasted. It's just wasted. Like, there's a scene where they had a perfect chance to demonstrate like a really cool kind of like an attack horror type of scene, but no, they just show the screen of the game, like an 8-bit type of game. They don't actually show what's happening, they just show the simulation of it happening. What the fuck? I don't know, this movie is all over the place. And the ending, you were like, oh, it's gonna end now. And it's like, the music gets all like, doesn't end. Then you're like, oh, it's definitely gonna end now because these people die. No, it just doesn't end. They just add like, open-ended like sentences like, sometimes the player is you and the game is life. Like, stupid fucking shit like that. Like, who gives a fuck? I'm cursing so much in this and I'm so sorry. let me just check my notes and see what else I wrote down. This movie is also inconsistent. Like, for the 3 out of the 4 games, there's no narration. And then for the second one, there's just a random voiceover of some man on this computer speaking. You don't find out why this game was really invented. It was like an experiment. And then you... I don't know. It was just so bad. I feel like I could talk shit about this movie for so long, but I'm not gonna... I'm gonna save my breath because... That's like, not even 90 minutes, that's like 85 minutes I'm never gonna get back. But you know what, I'm not mad about it because I can actually be like, this is a shit movie and I can definitely fucking identify that that movie sucked. Anyway, if you put my hood back on, I'm gonna chill, I'm gonna relax because I feel like I should not be getting this heated over a movie. I just, oh my god, it was the worst thing I've seen in definitely this year. I don't know if it was last, compared to, you know what, probably the worst movie I've seen in the last 2 years, and that's really, really saying something. So do not check this movie out, don't waste your time, watch something else, watch anything else, just don't watch this. That's all I gotta say about this movie. Anyway, this is the ending of this vlog. It's probably very long and it's been quite hectic because we went to Roscommon, we went to Donegal, we went to like, everywhere, and it's just been hectic, but I kind of enjoyed bringing my camera with me everywhere and kind of showing you more snippets of my life. So that was definitely really fun, and if you do like these longer types of videos, please let me know. I really would love some comments and some engagement and stuff like this, because you know what, this makes me really happy and I really love doing this, and it's something that I want to do for a long time. But anyway, enough of the passionate speeches. Thank you so much for watching this video. Let me know if you watched any of these movies, and if you have, you know, we can DM me on Instagram at Pavel Spam, or you can leave a comment, and please like and subscribe because it generally does really help me and the channel grow so much. Thank you if you've made it this far. Ooh, I'm out of breath for speaking so fast. I'll see you in the next video. Lots of love. Bye bye. Oh, before I go, actually, I always ask at the end of my videos, what movie should I watch next? Let me know. Let me know. Pick something and I'll watch it now. Goodbye.